Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpy, and this is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the price of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that to some extent, the prices of the major cryptocurrencies have rebounded for the last 24 hours. Of course, this is a slight price rebound, but anyway, this is something positive in my view, because we know that a few days ago, the prices of the major cryptocurrencies declined significantly by approximately 10 to 20%. So this is something nice. And of course, if we let's check the chart illustrating the market cap of the cryptocurrency market, in my view, there is no clear direction at the moment, and we cannot say that this is a beginning of a solid, sustainable bull run. Neither I would say that this is, let's say, some kind of downtrend. So the market is fluctuating and trying to find direction. And I want to compare it to some extent with the prices of the stocks or the major indices. And for example, let's take Standard & Poor's 500. So this is the price dynamic for the last 1 year. We know that the financial markets experienced solid price decline in the second half of February and in the first half of March because of this coronavirus uncertainty and difficult situation for the economy. But since the beginning of March, the financial market or the different segments of the financial markets, they have rebounded, and we see some similar price dynamics in the price chart of the cryptocurrencies. But this is, let's say, this rebound, for example, if we check the price of Bitcoin, and I just showed this rebound in the price chart of the total market cap, but let's take Bitcoin because it is the most indicative chart among the charts of the other cryptocurrencies. We have something similar for the last 1 year. So this is the, let's say, increase that took place in the first months of the year. Then in February, we saw this solid price decline, and then the price rebounded, the price of Bitcoin and the prices of the major cryptocurrencies as well. Similar situation we can see in the price chart of Standard & Poor's. And what I want to say is we see this correlation recently between the price charts of the different financial assets, including stocks, US indices, cryptocurrencies, and etc. And in my view, one of the main factors behind this, let's say, correlation between the price charts of these different financial assets is the current economic situation. And we know that the global economy experienced once again, because of this coronavirus uncertainty, solid uncertainty, and of course, it impacted the prices of the financial assets. And in my view, if this situation is solved, if let's say this uncertainty slowly but steadily disappear, we will see some positivity in the financial market and the price charts of many assets, including stocks, including cryptocurrencies. They will express some positivity, and who knows, it may trigger the next, let's say, the beginning or the next uptrend, bull run. And that's why, as I told in my previous cryptocurrency market overviews, I think it would be nice if we see improvement of the current economic situation. That's why today I will check and mention and comment on some indicators relating to the global economy, in particular the European economy, the US economy, and etc. So if we check, for example, the different economic indicators relating to different regions all over the world, mainly we can witness that the situation is quite similar. That's why let's start with the European economy, because I'm based in Bulgaria and we're part of the European continent, and etc. So this is, for example, the flash services PMI for the month of May. So this is some preliminary data or survey. Let me show you the dynamics of this indicator. Of course, we know very well that this decline was very solid. I commented on these indicators. But now the preliminary data for May Of course, we still see this column below the critical, let's say, line or level of 50.0, but at least it looks a little bit better than it used to be last month. This is the French Flash Services PMI. The same holds for the manufacturing sector. So we see a slight improvement. I won't say that this is a positive, let's say, indicator. Yes, it is in the negative zone or in the negative territory, but still, this is a positive dynamics when we see this rebound. If we check, for example, the German economy, slight rebound in the manufacturing PMI, slight rebound also in the services PMI or indicator showing what the situation in the manufacturing services sectors are. This is the European manufacturing PMI. So the European manufacturing sector has improved slightly if compared to the previous month or for, to the month of April. The same holds for the services PMI. And to be honest, let's get to the site of this institute or research institute market and have a look at those surveys. This is the US composite PMI, UK composite, Eurozone. Let's click on the, for example, this is the US economy. And this is the chart. So this is the recent decline of activity in the US economy. Of course, this local low dropped below the local low that formed during the global financial crisis. So let's hope that this will be a V-shape, let's say, recession, and the economy, the global economy, I will cross my fingers for it, that it improves faster, and this is a V-shape recession. But let's just check some information relating to the US economy. And once again, you see this rebound that is supposed to happen in the current month of May. So US private sector firms reported a slightly slower rate of contraction of activity in May as the economy began to reopen. So I consider this as something positive. Of course, if we check additional information, we will see that we anticipate the GDP will decline at an annualized rate of around 37% in the second quarter. This is a massive decline. But of course, let's hope that we will witness some improvement. So once again, of course, most of the, let's say, sub-sectors of this economy is experiencing some difficulty. But anyway, I find this a little bit more positive if compared to the month before. Once again, a slightly slower rate of contraction of activity in May. The same holds for the European economy. You can see, for example, that the European economy experienced a solid decline, a very sharp decline in the previous few months. So this local low is significantly lower than if compared to the one that happened during the global financial crisis. But let's hope that the rebound will happen faster. And we witness at the moment the first attempts of improvement. And of course, let's read some information about the current economic situation according to market institute. So the Eurozone economy remains stuck in the in its deepest downturn ever recorded in May due to the ongoing measure taken to control the coronavirus disease, according to provisional PMI survey data. However, the rate of decline eased as parts of the economy started to emerge from lockdown. So I also find this last sentence as some positivity for the market. Of course, also expectations, for example, expectations of output in the coming 12 months, meanwhile, rose for a second successive month for March's all-time low. So this is also some kind of improvement because we see that businesses, they express some positivity towards the next 12 months. So this is something nice, albeit with the number of pessimists continuing to exceed optimists and the overall level of sentiment remaining below anything recorded before the pandemic. Of course, we are still in this, let's say, difficult economic situation, but let's say there is a light at the end of the tunnel. So probably we will see some improvements of the economic situation in the next few months. And for example, let me read one more sentence that is in the comments at the end of this document. So this is something, let's say, as a conclusion. All Eurozone countries eased their COVID-19 containment measure to some extent in May, helping to moderate the overall rate of economic decline. Of course, we understand that those restrictions will still, let's say, limit the speed of recovery of the European economy, but at least we see some improvements, once again, helping to moderate the overall rate of economic decline. And once again, I would like to say that, in my view, if the global economy improves, it will benefit or it will impact positively not only the prices of the stocks, but also the prices of the cryptocurrencies, because, fellas, you know, if people all over the world, they have work, they go to work, they receive money, They won't need to exchange their crypto to cash it out in order to be able to pay for their bills. That's why, as I used to say before, if the global economy improves, then it will support the prices of the cryptocurrencies as well. And I cross my fingers for the global economy to recover as soon as possible. And let's hope that this is the beginning of some rebound. And we are, of course, in the early phase of this rebound. But I will be happy if in the next few months we see continuation of this rebound once again, because it will be better for all the people living all over the world. And of course, at the end of the day, the cryptocurrency enthusiasts will benefit in the cryptocurrency market from it as well. That's it for today, fellas. Today's Saturday. I wish you a wonderful weekend and hope to see you in the next one. It was me at CryptoSpark.